This flight will be taking us from Nelson in north of New Zealand, north of the South Island, to Christchurch. It's roughly 150 so miles. Longest trip we've done on this world tour so far in one leg. We've got some mountains to cross, and hopefully we should be having some fun on the way with flying the Mustang. Flaps up. Third thing might be a taxiway. This is one of these 4 foot wide runways, so there's a good chance we'll be veering off into the grass slightly, but not too much. It's not too long either, so we're going to be swift with this. Gears up, here we go, we're good. First thing I want to do is get rid of this rudder trim. So we're stable in a climb. There we go. Close the canopy, and if I get bad views on this recording, I will definitely keep it open next time. We could fly up to 20, 30,000 feet and use some oxygen, but I'd rather keep it low to look at the mountains here. It'd be quite possible normally to just put the autopilot on and cruise for like 100 miles. It'd be very boring. Some sections you might do it, you might have put the outside views on. Okay. The plan is to fly through valleys when we see them. There's one ahead up here. So we might do some dives and climbs. Spot something, we'll have a closer look. Meantime, I see a valley ahead, so let's do a little bit of a dive in here. If we get two, we can shoot this one and the one over here. In the direction without being in the water. I'm going to go to the right because I like to look at the water. And we can't fly straight the whole thing, it's kind of boring. There's also a road here, so a good chance it might be settlements or something. We've already gone almost 40 miles. We've lost the VOR now because we're low. But we know where we are. had to go down the left valley would be another exciting dive. I think I'm going to think about it for a second. Make sure we can see where we need to go. What have we got down here? Boat look pretty.
I think
got a lake there. Or a valley. Gotta miss one. Have to go over there. Not a spot you wouldn't be caught in and playing that pattern. Mustang absolutely excels at this kind of exploration. I'm doing a huge amount of talking here because I don't need to. I think the scenery speaks for itself, and I'm concentrating on flying this beautiful machine. I'll also make sure I don't have abused the engine. We're all well within our limits. slowing us down to check all my meters, so yeah, I'm worried about not being able to see oil pressure, which is high. Be overdoing it. Okay, let's get back on track for the airport, which we're now only 50 miles from. We've almost travelled 100 miles already. Very fast machine. We're almost coming out of the mountains now. It's a shame. Maybe we need to do one more little valley trip, because we're out of the mountains and we'll be straight down to Queensland. Relatively flat. It would be an amazing flight to go down the whole range of these mountains, all the way down south to Queensland or Milford Sound, but we've got a trip planned for Christchurch, so we're going to do it. And I don't want to push my luck and blow the engine up or something after all this fun. Just reach the RPM to something more cruise level. Get the oil temperature down, pressure, temperature, okay. We're riding a bit higher for a while, so I'd like to get that down to the green zone. Tune into Christchurch 80s in a second. Okay, temperature's good. I will check. I think the 80s is already tuned in. There we go. That's a bug. I mean, that is an interesting. Doesn't they have that many runways? Okay, that could be a. Look at that line of runways. Well, we'll tune to the control tower and they'll tell us where we're going to go. 118.4. I want to shut that guy up. Christchurch. Runway 2, 3, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Runway 11. Altimeter 3003. Well, the airport is straight ahead of us. I'm going to tune this into 11. Make it even easier for us. We travel quite fast, so when I get to like 10 miles out, I can make a right turn. But possibly that's it, yep. And there's a runway. You can see it plainly. Holding the altitude to bring the speed down to 170 to put the gear down. We'll turn in. Have a climb quite a lot, but that will go. Okay, now we can. That would descend much faster. Quite a big FPS drop here. See, it's pretty jerky. This airport is very FPS heavy. Okay, don't know about that now. Right. Got a lot of white road on here. Quite a bit of a crosswind. Seems to be. I was getting worried that that would be an interesting landing. I got a little bit of gust of wind and I could have been all over the place. Yeah, terrible frame rate, but it's Christchurch. It's probably about the worst in the whole New Zealand area. Apologise for that.
sounded a bit rough, but everything seems to be fine. It. Okay, well, that's good. How much fuel did I use? Probably might be the fact that the engine oil was, well, just dirty. Kind of gave it a bit of a run through. And we used that much fuel. Okay, thanks for watching that rather exhilarating flight. Our next leg is to Tekapo, back at the foot of the mountains, where we'll be switching to a smaller plane for some local landings. We've got a big runway, so I'm on my way, so I should be able to do a smooth takeoff. No need to rush this. First leg we did was pretty well panic mode. I'll just gotta set, reminds me, I'll set my elevator trim. Low frame rate, this makes takeoff a bit more interesting. Ground with only 50 manifold pressure. It's a long runway. I've got a turn, just give it this rudder trim, which broke me off. Could fly really low, I mean, make it more interesting, but maybe we should. But no reason to fly, so just flat ground, we might as well fly. At 1,000 feet or 500. We've got flat ground between us and the VOR behind us, so we don't have to worry about losing our signal. I think down to 1,000 will be respectable. Again, breaking the aviation laws by flying it, being the knots at this altitude. Seeing the plane wants to climb, I'm probably risking outside view. Let me see this river in its glory.
I'm porpoising a little bit because I am making sure I don't get anywhere near the ground while I'm doing this. That's a great view of that river. That's hard to lie like that. If I do a bank, got a reasonable 280 knots at 2,500 feet. A dry river bit there. Some of the mountains further down south here are 14,000 feet tall, which makes interesting flying in a small plane. Oh, I'm talking about a small plane, that's in Cherokee. Back from memory, when I get towards that second peak, I don't want to be flying over the runway's white ground level basket, so I'll fly around to the left of here, come in. It's also the runway there as well. Whenever I go to a side view, I let the plane climb a little bit to be sure that I don't hit anything. You know, the scariest part of this flight will be the landing.
5 miles out.
And so from memory, it's behind those ridges there. So if we come in this way, we might be pretty much straight in for a landing. So let's kind of trim this. Pretty well want to get over this little ridge here. I want to put the gear down. Because I want to fly straight in, so I'll better to be safe. There's a peak. So we're 2,500 feet above the airport, which is just around this corner. And I don't need this anymore, so I'm going to set that to 29 to remind me where we there the runway is. Lovely mouse messing up. Or maybe eventually on a best not bad view. Now we're cruising very slowly, and almost 60 FPS as well, so that's nice. So no excuses for not getting a control and landing. Canopy down. Out open, I mean. Yeah, there's the runway. Tiny little thing. Press the flaps down so we can stabilize it. So the wind is really, it should be with us. There should be no more than a couple of knots. Should be. Cross wind. or down on the runway. I think it was three wheels. So if you could slow down, please, I'll be very happy with that. Yeah, but I looked to the right for the video before we're landing, which meant I dropped a little bit low. Well, there's people, a person. Wood cabin.
It's a pretty finish. We're at Tekapo, NZTL, where the Mustang will be retired for the night. And I will hop in a Comanche or a Cherokee.